This was yesterday, 1886, a year memorable for many events as the world meandered unhurriedly toward the threshold of the 20th century. Grover Cleveland was in office as the 22nd President of the United States. A Navy man by the name of Robert E. Peary prepared to take off on his first polar expedition to the Arctic Circle. And from the Brooklyn Bridge, legend has it, a fellow known as Steve Brody also took off on a daring leap into the East River. The latest Paris creations from Brody's ladies' book showed that the bustle was still shaping up as a favorite with the ladies, who were also enraptured by the miracle of recorded music, made possible by Mr. Edison's remarkable invention. The pace of life was beginning to quicken. Electric trolleys were being put into regular service in major cities. Gottlieb Daimler developed the internal combustion engine, and not long afterwards, Charles Duryea drove the first saleable horseless carriage down an American road. As the wheels of progress speeded up, new companies came into being. Their aims and activities linked to this march towards mechanization. And of all the new businesses established in 1886, one in particular was destined to grow into a major force in the petroleum industry. Occasion of this 75th anniversary, one may ask, how far has Sun Oil Company really come in three generations? How does it fare in the petroleum-powered world of superhighways? And in the jet-streamed skyways that are the gateway to outer space? An even more searching question is, what's ahead for the Sun Oil Company and you, the more than 9,000 Sunoco dealers? The answers can be provided by the president of the company, Mr. Robert G. Dunlop.
I'm very pleased to enjoy this opportunity to talk to you about what the future holds. And certainly, this is a very fitting time to think along these lines. For in this year, 1961, we celebrate the 75th anniversary of the Sun Oil Company. The events of 1886 seem remote and far distant, and yet, in the next 25 years, some of the opportunities that are ahead of us are going to seem even more strange in contrast with the world as we knew it in 1886. Of course, many of the developments of the future are still on the drawing boards, but in the light of the developments that have taken place technologically over the last 75 years, I'm sure that we can have great confidence that the fantasies of the future will be realized within the next 25 years. In fact, I do not think it is unrealistic to assume that we may be living in solar homes, or riding robot-controlled automobiles, or there may even be spaceships stationed out from the Earth to the Moon. I have always been impressed with the words that appear over the entrance to the National Archives in Washington. The past is prologue. Certainly out of the past, we do get an indication of the accomplishments that take place. Sun Oil Company, as you know, is responsible for several significant innovations in the field of refining and marketing gasoline. The first of these occurred in 1927 when we introduced premium gasoline, which sold competitively at regular gasoline prices. This was really a tremendous accomplishment, caught on immediately, and served the motoring public over the many years which we followed that policy. And then in 1937, there was the introduction of catalytic cracking, and the first large-scale commercial cracking unit was built at the Marcus Hook Refinery. That unit not only resulted in a greater yield of gasoline per barrel, but in addition made a much higher quality gasoline. In fact, the existence of those plants in the Sunoco Company refineries during the war was the reason we were able to make the great contribution which we did to the war effort. The third of these innovations, which is of interest, is one which occurred within recent years, and that was the introduction of the custom blending system. I always take pride in the fact that the Sunoco service station is selling more on average than any of the competitive locations. When the Sun Oil Company engages in research and develops better waxes and petrochemicals, greases and oils for lubricating purposes, then out of that situation comes improved motor fuel and improved motor oil. To give you, the Sunoco dealer, a first-hand look at what's going on in the current operations of Sun Oil Company, I would like to invite you to see some of our major operations.
In a modern refinery complex like this, hundreds of quality products are produced. This particular refinery is Marcus Hook, on the bank of the Delaware River, about 17 miles south of Philadelphia. Approximately 2,000 activity-packed acres, developed at a cost of millions of dollars, a far cry from the 82 acres originally bought in 1901 for $45,000. At Toledo, Ohio, this modern refinery complex supplies products mainly for the western portion of Sun Oil's market. And in Canada, at Sarnia, Ontario, Sun's newest refinery has been operating since 1953. Here at Marcus Hook, the capacity for crude oil intake is 160,000 barrels a day. While all three refineries are equipped to handle a total of almost 275,000 barrels. Sun Oil engages in a worldwide program of oil and gas exploration to assure an adequate supply of crude oil for Sun refineries and to establish petroleum reserves for future expansion. Wells are drilled deep below the Louisiana bayous and in widespread areas of the United States, Canada, and oil-rich Lake Maracaibo in Venezuela. Overall, Sun produced in 1960 almost 55 million barrels of crude and liquid. In addition, the natural gas production related to oil on an energy basis totaled over 49 million barrels. From far-flung oil fields, a modern fleet of tankers brings the crude oil to the Marcus Hook refinery. The Texas Sun, with a capacity of over 370,000 barrels, ties up at the dock. Capable hands link the hoses to the ship, and in less than 14 hours, the cargo is unloaded, pumped out at the rate of 30,000 barrels an hour. From well to refinery, whether coming by pipeline or tanker, it takes round-the-clock skills of Sun Oil people to keep the crude oil moving. The raw material comes in through this intricate network of pipes. Each line important, each laid out precisely to feed the raw material to different refinery plants, where dozens of installations produce hundreds of products for man's needs in a modern world. crude topper where the initial step in refining begins. A lube plant that produces high-quality lubricating oil. A vacuum tower that distills wax. An alkylation plant for the production of high-octane components for Sunoco gasoline. Poking its head more than 360 feet skyward is the Hoodriflow Tower. This is a modern version of a catalytic cracking process which Sun Oil introduced in the United States, standing as a major contribution to the petroleum industry. But equipment, however miraculous in its function, is only as efficient as the hands which guide it. In complex nerve centers like this, the experienced men of Sun Oil control the flow of every gallon of crude oil that comes into the refinery, guiding it through intricate processes that result in the many finished products. Man is the key to continuous, efficient operation, an unmatched combination of skill and experience helping shape a better future by rigid control of the present. All along the line, the men and women of Sun Oil are continually checking the finished products. Whether it is gasoline, Sunoco heating oil, or any other product made by Sun, each must continue to meet the company's high quality standards in actual use. What comes into Marcus Hook as raw, black crude oil flows out not only as gasoline, but in many other forms, including automotive fuels, Sunoco heating oils, aviation gas, jet, diesel, and distillate fuel. From these storage units, products are distributed as needed to Sunoco's vast marketing area. Just as Sun uses pipelines to move crude oil to the refineries, so does the company distribute a large part of finished liquid products by pipeline to strategic terminal points, such as this modern installation at Owosso, Michigan. Sunoco gasoline and fuel oil are transferred to trucks for the final stage of their journey from the refinery to the consumer. While many products are handled in bulk by pipeline and truck, Sunoco motor oils reach the customer in familiar cans, filled automatically by a fantastically fast and efficient operation. Until the filled cans are packed into their shipping cartons, not a hand touches the product. Other lubricating oils are also packaged here in large drums. Sun Oil has been a pioneer in the development of new industrial lubricants. As a leader, it has continually worked closely with industry to help meet the ever-changing, more exacting industrial lubricant needs of a growing America. There's a long list of industrial uses, from refrigerator units to giant turbines, including metalworking oils, transformer and rubber processing oils, where Sun Oil is looked to for leadership in providing the exact, the best, the most effective lubricant. Another widely sold Sun product is wax. It is shipped out either as a liquid or in solid blocks like these being processed here. There are 56 different types of wax made here from 7 different base grades. These particular solid blocks have been prepared for coating milk cartons. Other grades are used in making lipsticks, floor and auto polishes, candles, wax paper, and many other products. And there's still more that comes out of a barrel of crude oil. A whole field of petrochemicals used to create hundreds of different synthetic products. The propylene produced at Marcus Hook is converted into polypropylene film and fiber in this affiliate company plant, owned jointly by American Viscose Corporation and Sun Oil. The synthetic films and fibers are then used in the manufacture of many different consumer products. From Marcus Hook, Sun supplies another raw material extracted from crude oil. An affiliate company, jointly owned by Olin Matheson and Sun Oil, produces the modern chemical fertilizer called urea. Most of this chemical is shipped to farmers in easily handled packages for use as animal feed and fertilizer. Progress, quality, and new ideas. These are the goals of the Research and Development Division. Here, a continuous program of testing and experimenting is carried on. Technicians from practically every branch of science use modern technological instruments like this computer to find ways and means of improving today's products and to develop new products that must keep pace with the fast-moving world of tomorrow. Not only products for the automobile and airplane, but also for all types of industry and agriculture. In these laboratories, all the tools of modern science are used, such as this electron microscope that magnifies an engine deposit as much as 60,000 times. A spectrometer for analyzing the composition of new products under development. A hydromagnetic shock tube to test the ignition characteristics of motor fuel. Machines to test the tensile strength of different types of rubber produced with Sun's rubber processing oils. The results here will be applied to improve the quality and safety of tomorrow's tires. Experiments in the blending of a variety of additives to create better and more efficient lubricating oils and fuels. Continuous experimentation with various wax compositions to develop more resistant, stronger coatings for paper. All part of Sun Oil's research in that never-ending quest for better products. But of greater significance to the Sunoco dealer is the continuing quest which involves the men at Sun Oil and the machines familiar to everyone, the automobile engine itself. Here, experienced eyes note the results when different grades of motor fuels and oils are tested in different engines under varying conditions. No matter how often these experiments are performed, no matter how often the switch may be turned to start the car, this research would be of no significance without the careful conclusions of Sun's, most of whom have spent nearly a lifetime in a constant endeavor to find the answer that ultimately spells better products. Scientific investigation, exhaustive tests, the finest in manpower and equipment. These combine to make Sunoil one of the leading suppliers of quality petroleum products. This product leadership, plus the sincere interest of you service-minded Sunoco dealers, your constant and professional attention to motorist needs, whether large or small, the goodwill achieved by the continual courtesy and pleasant manner you display, all this truly creates custom service.
Yes, it is teamwork that gives real meaning to the words, stop at Sunoco and go with confidence. What you, the dealers, are doing out in the field, we are trying to do here, spells success for the future. Together, we're shaping our future today. And I can assure you that the men and women in Sun's Research and Development Laboratory are not satisfied with the present. Their constant urge is to improve for the future. It is this restless searching, this desire to progress, not only by the researchers, but by all Sun people, that has spurred the consistent growth of our company. And the versatility and scope of Sun's operations reflect this ability to move ahead with the times. The multitude of activities here are a window to the future for us all, from the driller in the oil field, to the refinery employee, to the Sunoco dealer at the pump. And this power to progress, this determination to look ahead to tomorrow and the day after, must benefit all of us. It is a self-generating power that comes from a strength and a confident belief in ourselves, in the continuity of newfound opportunities, and in the ever-expanding horizons of the petroleum industry. This is our power for progress.